In this video, we'll discuss how and from where we get so many font support in Figma. Also, if you need custom fonts, how can you support custom fonts in Figma? Let's see how to do it. I've created a page called Font Support here. We'll now enable the text tool and write some text. Google Fonts plays a big role in our work. Here it is written in inter font. Now when we come to the text box and click on this select drop-down, we can see many font options. It means that now there is a support for many fonts. We can change the style of the text by selecting the font. How can we get support for so many fonts here? That can be a question. Let's see. As many fonts as you can see here, they are supported by Google Fonts. If these fonts are not supported here, how would I solve it? Figma has this main menu options for this. Hovering over the preferences menu of this main menu, in this drop-down, we can see a menu called Show Google Fonts. Here this menu is checked, means Google Fonts support is enabled, so we can work with Google Fonts. Now, if this checked menu is unchecked, then we will no longer get Google Fonts support. Let's see. Now, can't see previous fonts here. It means Google Fonts are not loading anymore. Her Indoor and Roberto font Figma supports by default. Again, if you want to provide Google Fonts support, then go to the Preferences menu from this main menu and check Show Google Fonts. Another thing, now if you need any custom font support apart from Google Font, then how can we get that support? Now let's see the font my computer. For that, I search by typing font in the search option. Find the Helvetica font from here. We can see the Helvetica font. This is not a Google font. Let's see if this font is supported by Figma or not. Look for the Helvetica font here. No, we can't see the font here. So, how can I get local fonts in Figma? For that, we need to download a font support installer. We enter this link figma.com/downloads. Installer file link for desktop app, mobile app, along with font installer, Windows and Mac OS can be seen here. Since I am on Windows OS, I downloaded the Windows installer. Then install this file. Let's check if font installer named Figma Agent is installed or not. Here is the Figma Agent installed. This Figma agent will now support local custom font in Figma. Now let's check if the font called Helvetica is available in Figma. No, we can't see it yet. The font installer we installed is not loaded into Figma 8. So we reload Figma. Okay, reload completed. Now let's check again to see if I can find the font called Helvetica in Figma. Here's the font called Helvetica in Figma. This means the custom font are now supported by Figma. After receiving the text, some settings of the text are required. From this text block, we can set the text. From this drop-down, we can change the font of the text. You can change the weight of the text from this option. From here, you can increase or decrease the font size. This is the line height. Through this, we can increase or decrease the height of the text line. And if you want the default line height, you will set the value to auto here. I can manage the letter spacing by increasing or decreasing the value here. By using paragraph spacing, we can increase or decrease the distance between multiple paragraphs. It is auto width. It is used to auto width the text. This is auto height. It is used to auto height the text. The fixed size options is used to fix the width and height of the text. They are used for horizontal alignment, text horizontally from left, center or right side. They are used for vertical alignment, text vertically top, middle or bottom. Also from this ellipsis icon options, we can manage some mode settings. Almost all of these settings here are external. There is additional justify alignment which was not out. Through this, you can justify the text align horizontally. From this decoration option, you can make text decoration none, underline, strike through. It was the paragraph spacing that was out. You can add a space at the beginning of the specified paragraph indent. Here is the list style. If you want to style the list, you can create a bulleted list and number list from here. You can manage cases, change lowercase to uppercase, title case, etc.